You are listening to Advent Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace, siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
We will wait upon the Lord. His presence is fullness of joy, fullness of joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Tuesday, the 22nd of December, 2020, fourth week of Advent, 3 days before Christmas. A day of gratitude for whatever the Lord has done for us. Hannah does that. Mary does that. What about you? Let us pray. O God, who seeing the human race fallen into death, willed to redeem it by the coming of your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that those who confess his incarnation with humble favor may merit his company as their Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Antonia Oyem, a Daily Bread member from Lagos, Nigeria.
A reading from the first book of Samuel, chapter 1, from verse 24 to verse 28. After she had weaned him, she took him to Shiloh, taking along a 3-year-old bull, 10 kilograms of flour, and a leather bag full of wine. She took Samuel, young as he was, to the house of the Lord at Shiloh. After they had killed the bull, they took the child to Eli. Anna said to him, "Excuse me, sir, do you remember me? I am the woman you saw standing here praying to the Lord. I asked him for this child, and he gave me what I asked for. So I am dedicating him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he will belong to the Lord." Then they worshipped the Lord there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Joseph Nakakua, a Daily Bread member and an oblate of Mary Immaculate, working in Gobabis, Namibia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 1, verses 46 to 56. At that time, Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of low degree. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his posterity forever." And Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and returned to a home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we are focusing on the gratitude we have to show to God whenever God does something, whenever we recognize God at work in our lives. We see Hannah giving us an example. Hannah had prayed with tears for the birth of Samuel. She had asked the priest to pray for her, and Samuel was born. Hannah, honoring the Lord and realizing that it is the Lord who had done it, went to the temple of the Lord and met Eli and offered sacrifices. Look at what Hannah offered. Along with a three-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and she brought him to the house of the Lord at Shiloh. She didn't go empty-handed. No, she went with something that shows for sure she's happy with what God has done. And she offered Samuel to the Lord. That is why something special happened in the life of Samuel, who became a special figure in the history of the Bible and played a key role in the transition of the biblical judges to the institution of a kingdom under Saul, and again to the transition from Saul to David. He is the prophet of Jews and Christians alike. This man was able to become all that because of what the mother did. The mother did not just see the birth of Samuel as something ordinary. Anyway, it had to happen. It had to take some time, and it happened. So she would have gone on with her life. No, she went and offered him to the Lord. And because of Samuel, we have Samuel becoming the first judge-like, and then allowing Saul to take over as king, and then from Saul to David, and something became established because of Samuel. But mind you, this all happened because we have a mother here, Hannah, who was able to recognize and acknowledge the work of God at play here. Many of us experience the power of God in our lives. God is doing a lot of things in our lives. And you ask for prayers. You have asked for God to do this and that. And when that happens, you even ignore. You don't even tell the one you ask for prayers from that God has done something. You were looking for a job. And a job is found. A year later, you come and say, "Oh, Father, yes, I got a job last year as I prayed for. Now I'm asking for more prayers, Father, that you may pray for me that I may keep my job." When you got that job, you didn't go to the Lord to say, "Lord, thank you for this," and offer sacrifices. If you want something to be consolidated in your life, please acknowledge that it is the Lord doing something in your life. And don't go empty-handed to the house of God. Go with an envelope. Go and show that it is God who is at work in your life. That child you asked for and God gave you a child. Go to the house of God. Offer a sacrifice. You don't have to take an animal. Take something in monetary form and go and offer to the Lord. That is concrete faith. Showing gratitude. You know what gratitude does? Gratitude begs for more by that very fact of showing gratitude. When you tell somebody who has done something to you and you say, "Oh, thank you so much. I am so glad that you did this," that person will be compelled to even give you something more. But many of us get blessed by the Lord and we don't go back to say thank you to the Lord. Look at what Mary does. Mary confirms that what she's carrying in her womb is a gift of God. And so she prays the Lord in song. "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaid." He has looked upon me with my low estate. He has looked upon me in humility. And because of this, all generations will call me blessed. Because of this, all generations, except those proud generations who will not recognize Mary as blessed, who will just think Mary is just one of the women like any other. But those who will understand that this woman had received the greatest favor that can be accorded to any human being, those are the ones who may not praise. And those are the ones who may not recognize in Mary the blessed woman. Blessed Virgin Mary. Blessed Virgin Mary says, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. And this is a woman who knows how to show gratitude to God for the gift that God has given. This Christmas must be a celebration of gratitude. A lot of things have happened, terrible things have happened in this year, 2020. But we also have a lot of things that have happened which we have to thank God for. One of the things is that today, the 22nd of December, you are listening to this word. Others don't have that opportunity. Others are not here with us. You have every reason to thank God for this presence. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Tuesday to you.
Thanks be to God.
We will wait.